Hello guys and welcome to my craft desk. Tatiana is here with you today. I'm super excited to share this video tutorial where I'm going to illustrate how to make a fun and cute interactive spinner card. Today I'm playing with mini but not less adorable Shrimp Cocktails stamp set from Newton Snook Designs that contains two mini cuties. And since I have the coordinating dice for this stamp set as well, I sought to make an interactive spinner card. I started by stamping four couples of adorable shrimps. Today I'm working on Strathmore Bristol paper and use VersaFine Onyx Black Ink for stamping since it's crisp and waterproof. Next, I'm taking watercolor markers from Tombow and a small water brush from Pentel. I started the coloring with the initial color layer that I put on all the shrimps. Next, I'm adding a more strong orangey-red color towards the edges of the shrimps for a little bit of shading and spreading the color with my water brush. I'm scribbling the color marker on an acrylic block and picking a little bit more color for a perfect blend. Besides, I added a little touch of blue to the cocktail glasses and colored the liquid with a light yellow color. And the tiny olives inside the cocktail became green. I'm moving directly to the interactive mechanism and starting with a regular A2 side card base made from Nina Solar White paper. I've also trimmed another rectangle from the same Nina Solar White paper to fill the whole card front. I'm putting aside the folded card base for a moment and starting working on the additional panel. I'm making little marks at 3/4 inch from the top and bottom sides of the additional rectangle and connecting them with a line. I will be using this line as a guide for the correct positioning of the circle die cut. The circle die cut I'm using on today's project comes from Newton Snook Designs as well and takes part of their Frames Squared die set. I'm keeping inside the packagings some circles left from the previous projects that came super useful today to make the idea how to position correctly all the elements. I won't die cut the circle windows through the card base and the additional rectangle at once. For this purpose, I'm aligning both layers together and taping with a temporary sticky tape to prevent from any movement during the die-cutting process. I'm securing with the same tape the die-cut circles to prevent it from shifting and running back and forth 2 times inside my die-cutting machine to make sure that both layers are die-cut perfectly. All the steel dies from Newton Snook Designs are really high quality and I have no problem to cut both layers at once. I'm using the pencil lines we made before as a guide to position correctly all the die-cut windows. I obviously repeated the same process 4 times to achieve 4 circle windows. And now I'm slowly and carefully removing the sticky tape from the card front. At this point, I wish I had stuck the tape to the back of my hand before putting it to the project. But since I didn't, I'm helping myself with sand eraser from Tombow to remove the extra glue left on the card front. Next, I'm taking a super strong double-sided adhesive tape and started putting directly on the card base. I believe this fun interactive project is really simple and can be repeated by the beginning card makers as well. All you need is just take your time and slow down since all the alignments take quite some time. I'm obviously speeding this coloring process a little bit since it took me quite a while to make all these steps. When I finished to put the first layer of the double-sided adhesive, I'm taking a thin metallic thread and adhering to the cut base. As you notice, I'm also tying a little knot on all the string edges, just to secure it from unraveling and shifting away from the project. For this purpose, I'm also putting the second layer of the double-sided adhesive, and finally with a tiny touch of mono multi liquid glue adhering the cut front. Now our spinning interactive mechanism are finished and I can start gluing shrimp couples. Once again, I'm very generous with the glue and putting it on both sides of the shrimps. I'm using the grid on my craft mat as the guide for the alignment and putting together four couples of the shrimps. Since both images from the shrimp cocktails stamp set are mirroring, they fit perfectly together glued from the back side. I wished to keep the rest of the cut very simple and keep the main focus on the interactive mechanism. I flipped through my stash and found this light teal striped pattern paper that I glued directly inside the card base. It matches nicely sea theme plus goes well with a peak of blue I put on the cocktail glasses. Next, I'm taking a piece of a super light yellow cardstock and simply stamp on top the sentiment from the same shrimp cocktail set I used before. My ink choice was on VersaFine Onyx Black, and next I'm gluing it directly to the cut front with mono multi liquid glue I used before. And this cut is pretty much done. You can spin the shrimps, close the cut and put it like that in the envelope. On opening this cut, the recipient will be surprised with the fun interactive element and movement. Thanks so much for stopping by and have a good day.